WWE's recent Hell in a Cell pay-per-view turned out to be one of the most controversial shows that WWE have produced in many years. Everyone was looking forward to The Fiend vs. Seth Rollins, only to be let down by the terrible and baffling ending, with The Fiend kicking out of multiple finishers from Rollins, and the match being stopped despite it being a Hell in a Cell with supposedly no rules. It's now been revealed, thanks to the Figure 4 Wrestling Online newsletter, that there were originally another plan in place, but Vince McMahon ultimately went with what we saw on pay-per-view. Not that the ending was a lot better, but Vince McMahon's other idea was to have the match end with Seth Rollins throwing Bray Wyatt off the top of a cell in a very similar style to Mick Foley when he had his legendary match with The Undertaker. After Wyatt would get thrown off the cell, the match would still be called off by the referee, fearing for Bray Wyatt's safety. But then Bray Wyatt would get up afterwards and destroy Seth Rollins. The premise is basically the same in that the referee stops the match due to concern for Bray Wyatt's health, only for Wyatt to get up and then attack Seth Rollins, so the fans would have still undoubtedly been pissed. This ending, though, never took place, of course, and the ending that they did go with probably proved to be even more controversial and caused even more problems for the WWE. Vince McMahon was said to be laughing backstage about it, but it's obvious the backlash was huge enough that neither Wyatt nor Rollins appeared on Monday Night Raw, nor were they mentioned. The upcoming draft is taking place soon, and it's said that Paul Heyman wants to have The Fiend on Raw. Whether they'll do this and put Seth Rollins on SmackDown to keep them apart is anyone's guess, but it seems like whatever the plan was for Vince McMahon at Hell in a Cell, fans weren't gonna be happy. The Fiend has been their most popular character in a long time, and it's a shame that Vince McMahon doesn't seem to have any clue how to utilize him properly. Where The Fiend will go from here is anyone's guess, although reports say that The Fiend currently has a minor injury, so he may not even be on Raw SmackDown for the next week or two. We don't know what the specific injury is yet, but I'm sure we'll find out over the coming days. That said, we all hope that Wyatt gets well soon, and that somehow the pay-per-view ending can be salvaged. Whatever happens, I'll be sure to keep you all up to date. This is Wrestling Rambles 89, signing off.